Yo, how's it going, boys? Welcome back to the YouTube channel. Today we got all of these glorious action figures and plushies to unbox and review today. As you can see, I've got my hands on all six of the spring colorway FNAF plushies. Chocolate Chica, Chocolate Freddy, Chocolate Bonnie, and Easter Bonnie. I have two Easter Bonnies actually, one to keep in the box and one we're going to review today. As you can see, unfortunately, I am missing the Chocolate Bonnie plushie. I've tried my hardest to find it. It's not in my Walmart. If I get it sometime soon, I'll probably show it off at like the start of another merchandise unboxing video. But for right now, this is what we got to review today. So since we do have a lot of stuff, because it is almost the entirety of the Easter 2021 collection, let's not waste any more time. If you're new, thank you so much for clicking on the video. Please subscribe. We are so close to 16K. And also smash the like for more unboxing and review merchandise videos in the future. All right, now I got the knife. Which one do we want to take a look at first? Let's start off with some of the plushies. So first up, we have the spring colorway cupcake plushie. I really like these plushies because they are pastel and I freaking like, come on, those look so good. I freaking love pastel things. They look so amazing. And I mean, these are no exception. The colors that they used, well, I am aware that they're basically lighter color versions of the blacklight plushies. I don't care because they look so cuddly and so soft and so cute, and they also are so cute and so soft. The tags on these things are also awesome. They're Easter themed with the Easter eggs. God dang it, it's not focusing. But as you can see, it does have the FNAF AR logo, which is strange because these guys are not from FNAF AR. Again, as far as I'm aware, they're just slightly different colored versions of the black lights, so I'm not gonna take too much time on them, but again, they're cute, they're soft, I freaking love these things. Also, the cupcake has the same cardboard down at the bottom as the security puppet plushie right there, so they can stand up. Moving on to the foxies, we have the light blue and light purple pastel spring colorway foxy plushie. Since they're not really anything new, they're just the characters, the blacklight plushies just with lighter colors, I don't think we're gonna spend too much time on them. Again, they're all very soft. I love the cute little nose right here. And there's not really much more I can say other than they're soft, they're cute, I freaking love the colors. I'm gonna keep saying it because I really do love the colors. The second spring colorway foxy plushie is probably my favorite in the entire collection. It's light blue with pink. I think it works very well as a combination of colors. It reminds me a lot of cotton candy. All the tags are the same, so I'm not gonna show them off too much. But yeah, this is the second foxy plushie. Because Foxy is a fan favorite in the community, they made three plushies of him. I believe this was the same case with the normal blacklight plushies. Yeah, this plushie, it doesn't really show up well on camera, but it is a very light green with yellow accents. Wow, that is really not picking up on camera. That's so weird. It looks blue, but trust me, it's a very light pastel green. This one's probably my least favorite, not because the colors are bad, I just prefer the other combinations of purple and blue and pink over this one. And again, the tag is the exact same. This is the first out of two Freddy plushies, and as you can see, this bad boy right here is a light blue and light green. Unfortunately, my camera's not the best. Ooh, he also has pink accessories and a purple hat. What? This man's colors are all over the place. Is the tag? Yeah, unfortunately, my camera's not the best, so it doesn't really pick up the colors too well. But again, freaking love this dude. Also, the bow tie's amazing. I was feeling it on the way back there. It is a strange material, I will admit. Kind of a... I'm not a plushie expert. I don't know if they've used this before, but it is an interesting material. I'll give them that. All right, I must be a sucker for pinks because this guy looks amazing. He's pink with yellow and blue accessories. I don't know what's up with the bow tie. It's not a terrible material, but it definitely feels off when compared to the soft, smooth texture of the actual plushie. It's the same material as the hat. It's not bad. It doesn't take away from the actual plushie. I still freaking love it. It's so soft. And again, here's the tag. So that is all the spring colorway plushies. Now let's move on to the action figures. Now, unlike the Easter Bonnie action figure, I do only have one of Chocolate Freddy, Chocolate Chica, and Chocolate Bonnie. So unfortunately, we're gonna have to tear these boxes open. Before we do, I will state my opinion on them. I freaking love them. They look so good. I also like how they have different colors for depending on what character you got, right? Chica's pink, Freddy's kind of a light purple, Easter Bonnie's blue, and Chocolate Bonnie has a nice bright yellow to them. Here's the backs. Again, I freaking love the boxes for these guys. I don't know, like, what happened, but Funko really stepped up their game, right? There's his sticker at the front. Also, I don't know what's up with his arm. It's like bent like this. Anyways, let's get the knife out and let's get stabbing. So here is Chocolate Freddy out of the box. Now, because Chocolate Freddy and Chocolate Chica are, as of right now, Funko OC characters, I don't have any reference material to go off of for the figures, but it doesn't matter. Because I freaking love this guy. The amount of detail that they put into not only Freddy, not only Chica, not only Easter Bunny, not even like just Chocolate Bunny, like all of these figures have such good detail. They're easily, in my opinion, like some of the best figures that they've put out. The amount of detail on the paint job, the mold itself, all the bite marks taken out of him. He looks so good. And also like the movability, right? The flexibility that this figure has. And I guess not only, these figures, I believe Frostbear had it too. They have a lot of flexibility. Here's the back of him. Yeah, the amount of detail on this dude is incredible. I love the endoskeleton, the buttons, the bow tie. Look at those teeth, that face. It's such a good figure. And I honestly can't wait to see this guy in game. A lot of people are confused right now because, like I just said, Chocolate Freddy and Chocolate Chica aren't in FNAF AR. If I had to take a guess, I'm guessing they're coming in April. I mean, they're two brand new characters themed after Easter. You know, we've been getting a lot of events this year which have two skins, and also Easter, April. It just makes sense that they would come to the game. Like, why would Funko make Chocolate Freddy and Chocolate Chica if they weren't coming to the game? That doesn't make any sense. They've never done that before. My guess is these were just released early before the actual event took place. So yeah, that is Choco Freddy. My hand is so shaky. I'm so sorry, guys. Let's move on to Chocolate Chica. Oh, also, this Freddy doesn't have a microphone. He doesn't have any accessory. Neither does Chica, actually. No, like, Mr. Cupcake, so it's weird that they don't have any accessories. Like, how difficult would it have been to make a different design for a microphone, or for the cupcake, or just, like, put a little Easter basket for these guys? Anyways, moving on to Chica, I already talked about the box, how I like that it's different colors, and a lot of decorations with the Easter eggs. There's the tag. Alright, let's get stabbing. It wasn't in shot, but I did actually stab the box. And here is Chocolate Chica. Again, as you can see, no cupcake accessory, which is so interesting. It's such a weird choice. I personally feel like no Chica is complete without the cupcake accessory. I just bent her head. My only nitpick about Chocolate Chica and Chocolate Freddy so far is that I feel like they're too similar in design. I also wish the bib said something different besides let's eat, maybe like let's hunt or something for like, you know, Easter egg hunts. But other than that, I do like her design. Again, she's got bites taken out of her. I don't know. It looks like she's filled with like a peep. I don't know. She's got one on this side too. A lot of bites taken out of her, which is so interesting. Again, I feel like they're very design-wise and aesthetic-wise very similar, which I'm not too big a fan of. I wish they had gone for a different design for these guys. Not that the design is bad, but I feel like, you know, I feel like they could have been a bit more different because they look very much the same. Here's the head. I like the beak. I like the teeth. And yeah, it's a very nice figure. I wish it came with the Call of the Cupcake though. I would love to see what he looked like in Easter form. And now let's go on to Chocolate Bonnie, the third and final chocolate character. All right, so unlike Chocolate Freddy and Chocolate Chica, Chocolate Bonnie is actually a skin currently in FNAF AR. Again, love the box, yellow with Easter eggs all over it. Here's the back, and here's his tag, Poggers. It looks awesome. My only critique, actually I have a few. First up, upper teeth. Funko, why do you always do this? You fixed it with Frostbear. Why'd you go back? And also the obvious thing, I feel like he's a bit darker with the action figure than he is in-game. In person, he's actually much lighter, which is more accurate to his in-game appearance. But again, he needs to be a little bit lighter instead of a dark brown, more of a light brown, maybe even orange. And here is the Chocolate Bonnie Funko action figure. Yeah, so all the colors are basically on point. You would be able to see if my camera would focus. And I really have no nitpicks besides the few I mentioned. All the bite marks, especially on the stomach, look amazing. Some on the leg right there as well. Some on the ear. Everything about this figure is very good, actually. Again, besides a few minor things like the top teeth, the color, he also has a little chocolate tail, which I'm not sure as if that's game accurate or not. It might be, because I think Bonnie has a tail in FNAF AR, though I can't remember. And if this figure was just a bit lighter, I think it would definitely be probably one of, if not my favorite figures. Again, I think they've done a fantastic job with all four of these figures. They look absolutely amazing. So now we're gonna move on to the fourth and final figure for today, Easter Bonnie. As you can clearly see right here, I have one in the box and one out of the box. Since this is the only thing I found in stores for this video, I did grab two. And like I said, box very poggers. There's the sticker right there. It is a Walmart exclusive. Eggs look nice. Here's the back. Amazing. And here is the figure itself. The detail on the stomach is amazing, and it's honestly kind of the only thing to take a look at with this figure. The bow tie looks nice, the face looks nice, with the nose and the bright blue eyes. He also has a little tail, which again, I can't remember if that's game accurate or not. I'm sure it is, because Bonnie does have a tail, and it looks really nice. I'm surprised by how good the stomach looks. There's not really much to say with this one, because it is just kind of the stomach, and then everything else about Bonnie is white. But again, I think it looks very poggers. And that is almost everything in the new Easter FNAF Funko merchandise wave. Again, I am missing only one thing, that is the Chocolate Bonnie plushie. I'll state my opinion for it right now. I think it's amazing. Again, I don't know, in my personal opinion, I don't know what happened over at Funko. It was probably Scott with the whole thing's gonna be happening very differently going forward, but they've been pumping out some banger products. The next thing that we will review, at least for Funko, I believe comes out in May. I believe that's the new release date for the Security Breach, like, 12-inch statues. I bought both of them. They look amazing. I can't wait to receive them. So that's it for the video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all on the flip side. Thank you.